Good morning to all. I hope you all are understood all the concepts from previous lectures. Previous lecture on servlet. Now today I would like to discuss life cycle of a servlet and tracking using cookies. Yesterday we will see I already explained about how to do session tracking in servlet. Today only change is that how to track the session using cookies. First, I would like to tell about servlet life cycle. Three methods are there. I have already told that: init, service, and destroy. When your servlet class is loaded in life cycle of the servlet, the web container maintains life cycle of a servlet instance. Let us see the life cycle of the servlet. Servlet class is loaded. Servlet instance is created. Init method is invoked, service method is invoked, and destroy method is invoked. Five steps are there in life cycle. There are three states of a servlet: new, ready, and in. The servlet is in new state if servlet instance is created. Three states are there: new, ready, and in. The servlet is in new state if servlet instance is created. After invoking the init method, servlet comes in the ready state. First, it is initialized. The servlet is in new state if servlet first it creates the instance of that servlet. After invoking the init method, once the servlet is initialized, only once, and then servlet comes in the ready state. In the ready state, servlet performs all the tasks. When the web container invokes the destroy method, it shifts to the end state. Means it exits from the instance. Instance is exited. Servlet class is loaded. The class loader is responsible to load the servlet class. First request. The servlet class is loaded when the first request for the servlet is received by the web container. Servlet instance is created. The web container creates the instance of a servlet after loading the servlet class. The servlet instance is created only once in the servlet life cycle. For only one request, the instance is created. Another request, the servlet instance is created, but it initializes only once. And different requests are handled by service. The init method is invoked. The web container calls the init method only once after creating the servlet instance. The init method is used to initialize the servlet. It is the lifecycle method of the JavaX servlet.servlet. This class is there. Servlet interface. This is the syntax for init method. Service method is invoked. The web container calls the service method each time when request for the servlet is received. Means only once it is initialized the servlet, and different requests can handled by service method. If servlet is not initialized, it follows the first three steps as described above and then calls the service method. If servlet is initialized, it calls the service method. The servlet is initialized by only once. The syntax of the service method of the servlet interface is given below. All the interfaces are there, and these are the syntax: public void service, request and response, close servlet exception or IO exception. Destroy method is invoked. The web container calls destroy method before removing the servlet instance from the service. It gives the servlet an opportunity to clean up any resource, for example memory, thread, etc. whenever instance is created, then memory is allocated. Therefore, it is a duty to remove the memory, deallocate the memory. Therefore, it calls the destroy method. And the servlet is servlet instance removed from the service. This is the servlet life cycle. Three basic methods are there: init, service, and destroy. Here we have to see, use this site for practice of servlet, that is tutorialwrite.com. So many programs are given here, 12 programs are there, 12 assignments. If you want, practice that and see how to do that. Here all the programs are implemented here. See one by one, if any problem is there, ask me anytime. Cookies in servlet. Two types of cookies are there: session and persistent. Session, the life of a session cookie. As soon as the web browser is closed, this cookie gets destroyed. And persistent session cookies, they have expiration time. You can assign the time to expire the cookies. They are stored in the user hand drive and gets destroyed based on the expiry time. You can assign the time. If you assign 1 year, then it will keep as it is for 1 year. Cookies are also used for session management. We already seen that, how to do the session management using sessions, how to track. Here, when a user visits web application first time, the servlet container creates new HTTP session in session management by calling request.getSession. A unique ID is assigned to the session. For in session tracking, whenever session starts, it assigns one ID to the session. It assigns one ID to the session. Therefore, it can track using ID. The servlet container also sets a cookie in the header of the HTTP response with cookie name and the unique session ID as its value. How to differentiate session and cookie? The header is there. Cookie in the header of the HTTP response with cookie name and ID. Here in session ID is there, here with name ID is there and its value. The cookie is stored in the user browser. When you want to open google.com, the www.google.com is the cookie which is stored in the client side. Whenever we want to open that link, we use cookies which are stored at our machine. The cookie is stored in the user browser. The client sends this cookie back to the server for all the subsequent requests until the cookie is valid. Whenever you type www.google.com using cookies, it can directly send that address to the server. Server checks the request header for cookies and get the session information from the cookie and use the associated session from the server end. Here it identifies the cookie and stores the information about that session information and associated session from the server memory. The session remains active for the time specified in tag in web.xml. We can assign time in web.xml for the session. If tag is not set in web.xml, then the session remains active for 30 minutes. That is default time. It automatically removed after 30 minutes. Cookie remains active as long as the user's browser is running. As soon as the browser is closed, the cookie and associated session info is destroyed. So when the user opens the browser again and sends request to the web server, the new session is being created. Browser closed, the session is closed. But in cookie, it is stored into client side. Two types of cookies are there. Cookie based on the expiry time, as per the expiry time, session and persistent. Session cookies don't have expiration time. It lives in the browser memory as soon as the web browser is closed, this cookie gets destroyed. Persistent cookies, unlike session cookies, they have expiration time. They are stored in the user hard drive and gets destroyed based on the expiry time. We have already seen that session program yesterday. Today, I would like to explain how to send cookies to the client. Create a cookie object, set the maximum age and place the cookie in the HTTP response header. Create a cookie object, how to create that? Create a cookie object, cookie C is equal to new cookie, username and Chaitanya. Its name and value is there for cookie. Set the maximum age, C dot, set max age 1800, these are the seconds. Place the cookie in HTTP response header, response dot add cookie method. We can set the cookie to the client browser through response to add cookie method. Response.addCookie. How to read cookies? Here request.getCookies, I less than C.length, I plus plus, outprint name, get name and value. We can access the cookie. How to do that in Java servlet? Action is equal to login. Form action is equal to login. It is the servlet name. New user, username, password, submit. Here. We have to, yesterday's lecture, we have created first servlet and second servlet for session tracking. Here, like that, we have to create two servlets, my servlet 1 and my servlet 2. Here, we use my servlet 1 extend HTTP servlet, then doGet method is there. All the syntax, print writers, set content, settings are required for the display purpose. String name is equal to request.get parameter username, password, you can access that, print hello name, your password is, creating two cookies, here create C1 and C2 for username and user password. Then adding that cookies to response header, response.addCookie C1, response.addCookie C2. Print writer, here reference, it goes to another servlet, that is welcome is the servlet name. It goes to this servlet. java.io servlet, servlet.http, my servlet to extend HTTP servlet. Here, it accesses the get value from the username, the first cookie and second cookie. And displays here web.xml. That is login is the servlet name and welcome is the servlet name. URL pattern. These are the URL pattern. You can change URL pattern for second servlet that is welcome and first servlet that is login. Here we have to mention the URL pattern. Here login is the URL pattern for first servlet. After executing this program, username, password, submit, it displays hello Chaitanya and view details is the hyperlink. Here view details is the hyperlink. After pressing that, it accesses the values of username and password and display that values. I would like to conclude my lecture today. Yesterday we have to see how to create servlet and session tracking and cookies. Today's lecture we have to use cookies in servlet and servlet lifecycle. If you have any problem, you ask me anytime. Use that site. Here 12 programs are already implemented. Read that programs or execute that programs, then you will understood more precisely, clearly. Thank you.